Hello everyone. My husband said this sourdough star bread is the best ever that I have made for him. Please come to the kitchen with me. Welcome to Saigon Cook Travel. I am Saigon Cook. The recipe you can read it in the description box below. There's a written version there. So I have my leaven here, 190 gram, and I will start adding my ingredients: salt, sugar, oil. This sugar I do 7 grams, salt 2 grams, and oil 20 grams. If you want to use butter instead of oil, you can go ahead. And the water I do 40 grams, because I use a lot of leaven, that's why I need to adjust the water level accordingly. Now in the mixer, I mix the ingredients at low speed and add my water slowly. When it comes to the bowl like this, I increase the speed and knead more, like 3-4 more minutes until it's smooth. And you can test the window pane now. You can see in my hand the dough is very smooth. That's what you're looking for. And you test the window, and it does not break immediately. That's what you want. Now I make it into the bowl. I will cover and let it rest. So I let it rest for like 30 minutes. I give it a knead few minutes, like 3 minutes, and from that on, I will let it proof in the counter, and until 6:30, it go into the fridge, and it will be come out. Will be coming out tomorrow morning. In the meantime, I prepare the mixture to go in the bread. The cooked one is garlic, ginger, onion. I use 2 kinds of onions here, white, yellow onion, and red. I use a little red onion to make the color. But if you don't have the color, the red onion, you can use only 1 kind of onion. Because this is the cooked one, the uncooked parts go in the bread will be the herbs, the fresh herbs, and the dry herbs. So you will have a lot of greens. I've been making sourdough bread for quite a few years now, and it's very satisfying that you can feed your family with the good food, because the sourdough bread has digestion and good for your health. because it have a probiotics elements in it. But this one, when I finish it, I gave to my husband, and he said that this is the best ever. He loves it. The bread is soft and chewy, and fragrant with all the herbs, and the sweetness from the onion. I think this is the winner for your family, or if you want to give the gift to someone, because the star shape is festive enough and people will appreciate and think beautiful. My videos is a little long because I include the cutting onion ingredients and cooking. I want to share everything I know, how my nice skills is. I think it will benefit for someone. But if you are expert in the kitchen, you can skip to the parts that you need to, like the dough or something like this. When we move to Florida, is the warm climate place. I grow many things here. You know that I like the song. Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, cheese, rosemary, and thyme. So I have right now parsley, rosemary, oregano, and thyme. The sage I started a long time, but I am not successful yet. But recently I just seeded the sage, and I think that they grow up, and I'm so happy that I have a very small seedlings now. About my thymes, last time my it's too hot and they are dying, so I need to start the thyme over again. You can see this is my rosemary, so they are very torn. I need to get it down and more bushy. And this is my oregano. You can see they are very good. And when you cut into it, they are so fragrant. So I'm back into the house. I wash my sprigs. And now I will cut the rosemary and oregano. Earlier when I was talking, could see that I chop my green onions. I chop green onion into two parts, one white part separately and one green part. And these are dry one, dry oregano and parsley. I will add to the bread as well. I like the bread is very fragrant with many herbs like this. But if you don't like much herbs in your bread, you can skim say you want this spoon for dry parsley and one teaspoon for oregano and like a one tablespoon for each fresh one, but you can skim or add more. I don't think you should add more because this is the most fragrant already. You don't need to do much than this. So because I have a clean and new skillet, so I melt my butter on the skillet and I will put it into the small bowl here to use for brushing the bread later. Now, on to this skillet. Into it, this skillet, I add olive oil. My olive oil is Spanish olive oil. I bought at Costco a big bottle, but when I come home, I use a small bottle for every use, so that I don't need to bring the big bottle every time. I tend to do so with all my other herbs, oil. Now when my oil is hot, I add ginger, garlic and white part of green onion, and I let it fragrant, let them fragrant. And now I add the two onions and saute until it cook. And now I'm ready for the stuffing. You can see there, butter, cooked onion, dry herbs, and raw fresh herbs. Now in the morning, I take the dough out at 8:30. That means it go into the fridge 6:30 yesterday evening, and now 8:30 it's come out. And with this measurement, I will cut the my dough into, I divide my dough into three parts. That means will be three layers. I will run out each one into about 12 inches. That is preferable. If you do less than 11 and 12, they are very small. If you run bigger than this, they will be big and very difficult to handle. So this is sourdough. So you, when you run like this, when I run my dough into the circle, I try not to deflate a little bit. So whenever I can stretch, I stretch with my hands, and then when I need it to roll with the rolling pin, I will be very gentle to roll so that I don't deflate on the bubble inside and let my dough form. You can see now I'm stretching first, and then I will cover it and let it rest. And I will cook my star bread in this sheet So I roll my dough onto it so that it's easier to transfer. That's preferable, but when the dough is in the pan like this, it will be a little difficult if you use the long rolling pin. So you can do, I show you that I do on the counter as well. And when to transfer, it's not so that easy. You can see right now, I run it about 10 right now, but I prefer longer, bigger. So I try to run more out. You can see when I run, I try the dough gently. You can see. I stretch and run at the same time. Try not to tear. Just think like you do lamination, very thin, thin lamination. And because this is a circle, try to do it round. You can see one of my corner there is not round, that's why I try to make it so. Right now I can put it back onto the parchment paper and let them rise. When you're rolling like this, if you have difficulty of the dough that is spring back, you just cover them and come back after 5-10 minutes, then you will be rolling easier. You can see if I try to stretch too much, it will tear on me. You keep watching me rolling my dough. I think this is the most difficult part when we doing this stuff bread. The one solution for this, that you can do your dough more. If you have the dough that the quantity of dough more than this, you can stretch here not so thinly and easier for you. I like to take opportunity to say thank you for stopping by watching my video. If you are new to my channel, please like, share my video, and subscribe to my channel to show your support to me. I have passion for food, gardening, home improvement, and everything in between. I've been cooking and gardening for a long time. Everything I know, I like to share it with you. So please subscribe and share my video for many people know about it. Thank you. So now when I'm happy with the round circles, that I created, I brush the butter that I melted earlier. Actually, in this cold weather, the house is like 70 degrees. My butter come back frozen. So I just melted it again in the microwave. So I divided my stuffing into two, and they go on to first layer now. The stuffing, you can go to the edge. This is very forgiving because later you will enclose it. So now I am adding the fresh herbs, green onions, oregano, parsley, and rosemary. And then the dry herbs. And that's it. Now repeat the second layer, the same thing. I put my second round on top. And I start on over again. And you can see somewhere my dough was tear, was torn. See, I patch them back. It doesn't affect you. You won't see it when you enclose them and making the star. So I go ahead and do the same thing. Brush butter, add onion, and dry up and fresh up, and I will cover the top with the remaining circle. The onion, when you cook, it have natural sugar appears, so the bread will add sweetness to the bread. That's why, you know, when I started my dough, I use only 7 grams of sugar. If you don't like sugar, you can replace honey in place of sugar. And that's it. Now I'm on to the last layer, and I try to binge on the layer together. And after this, we will go to the fun parts that we make the stars. And I will go very slowly for you to see how I make the star. Look very difficult, but it's not. I use this small bone to put in the center, and I will start cut. First, I cut into 4 parts, starting from the edge of the bone. First cut will get you into 4. And now I will go divide each of the four into two. I was thinking to do three only, but I rethink, and I will make a four again from each four. You can see I divide into two again, and then two again. It's very easy to, you don't need to remember anything. I just first cut into four, and then each four cut into two, and each two cut into two. So total you will get 16 of them. Now I am at this point, we start making this star. You take the two adjacent and spin three times, and then you pinch them at the end to make it into one. I go again now. One, two, three. And pinch. I go ahead and do this again. I'm not sure that you can see clearly from the camera, so I do three times here. Okay, one more. One, two, three, and pinch. You can see each bar will go separate. So I will pinch them together so that make one horn piece. I hope you understand what I mean. That means when I done spinning, I pinch each of them together like this. So when they back, they not go separately. And that's it. I will cover with the damp towel and let it rise. The time I start shaping until the time that I'm bring back it in the oven is 2 hours, because I like the dough rest to stretch easy. Then I include the thigh in that weight. After that, you can brush the egg mixture on top, or the milk mixture, the cream mixture, or butter mixture on top to make your bread golden. When before I baking, I preheat the oven 425 degree, and I bake it at 10 minutes, and then lower the heat at 350 and bake 10 minutes more. Ta-da!
You see
it's very beautiful star bread, and you can just break it off like this and eat. My husband loves it. He said this is the best sourdough bread that I ever made for him. I'm so happy.
Thank you.
I hope you like my video and give it a try. Let me know how it goes. Thank you. Bye-bye.